To begin, let's try to reflect about what happens in the traditional classroom. So in such a classroom, what happens during class is mostly information transmission. That is, the instructor gives a lecture and student takes the notes. Sometimes instructor may ask questions to which students respond. Sometimes student ask questions to which instructor responds. What is happening outside the classroom? Is the activity of assimilation or the students getting some mastery over the content, and this is done by the instructor giving problem sets and assignments which students have to solve and submit. And now students may work individually or work in groups. Okay, so we will pause here for a minute for you to reflect upon what are the limitations or what might be the limitations of such a classroom. You can pause this video to write down your answers in a course journal. Okay, so having given you 1 minute to reflect, let us quickly look at some of the limitations. So during class, when there is information transmission that happens, the instructor is lecturing. So often as instructors, we think that we are the ones who are most excited about our content, but we don't know how many of the students are actually listening to us, right? So that is the one reason that students don't pay at most attention to the instructor's lecture, however good it may be and however good it that the students are. The second thing is the students assume that they can understand because they can follow the lecture. So this is a big drawback with the lecturing model. And even if we improve on lecturing by having some interactivity such as instructor asking questions, but in this case, often what happens is that these questions are answered only by few of the students, typically who are the toppers of the class, and others are left behind. On the other hand, when students ask questions, often these questions are also asked only by a few of the students, and sometimes the instructor makes an assumption that because a few students have understood and have asked some advanced questions, the entire class is able to follow at that level, and so the instructor sometimes unwillingly goes ahead with the material when a large part of the class has not been able to keep up, has not been able to apply the learning that has been transmitted in that particular session. So that is one of the limitations of traditional classroom from the during class perspective. Let us also look at the limitation of the traditional classroom from the outside class perspective during the assimilation phase. So now the instructor feels that, okay, I have given problems and assignments to the students, and if they do these problems and assignments, then they will attain mastery over the content. So now what may happen is that these problem sets and assignments may be too challenging for some students. On other hand, they may be too simple or boring for other students. So in both cases, students may not or may lose interest in solving these problems, and the instructor often does not come to know which student is having what type of difficulty. So instructor does not know which are the students who found it challenging, and instructor does not know which are the students who found it boring. So this can possibly lead to copying of answers. So the second reason is that students study individually or in groups, and this typically happens just before the assignment submission deadline or the exam, which may cause students to focus on the assessment and not on the concept mastery itself. So again, most of us are familiar and often say that, you know, students study only at the last minute. So considering that perspective, what is likely to happen in a traditional classroom is that even though the instructor has given lot of problem sets and assignments for the students to practice, all of this practice often for a majority of the students gets postponed to a few days before the exam. Right? That is a very common phenomena which we observe in our classes. So there will be those students who do it very diligently early, and there will be some students who will never do it. In both extremes are there. But for the large part of students will do it only when there is some forcing function such as submission deadline or an exam. So the drawback of doing that is that the students focus at that point because of the deadline on the assessment, and it is not on the concept attainment. So these are the two major limitations of the traditional classroom.